Hello YouTube, this is Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales, and welcome back to the Wales campaign. So, in the previous episode, we are starting to besiege Oxford with Rodri the Honest, and we're going to be very dishonest in this part. We're going to try and take Oxford, of course. Now, we do have some catapults which are currently having free upkeep while they are garrisoned in this fort here. They can probably be brought across in the next turn to reinforce if we take Oxford. And I think we want to take this. They have Bill Militia, which shouldn't be too much of a problem. They have Spear Militia and then the General. So they don't have much in the way of units. So we're going to attack and we're going to assault them now. We have a ram, so it's time to ram them at Oxford. And they don't have the reinforcing captain as well, which is even better. So they are slight favourites, although we have a better general than theirs. So let's fight this battle on the battlefield. Here we go, lads. Time for a battle. Rodri the Honest versus Hugh. Hopefully we can take Hugh out and win this battle, of course. With fire and blood we shall prevail. Fingers crossed, anyway. So here we're going to start the battle. Get the old ram in place. We don't have... Oh, we do have some bows. Oh, shit in hell. Right, we're going to... pardon me. We're going to grab these units and we're going to group them. And they aren't under fire. They're not in range, I don't think, from where they are. Hellweir Bowman can be brought up slightly as well, but they put them into a loose formation so they don't take as many casualties if they do get used. And what do they have on the walls? They have Spear Militias. They can't fire apart from the towers, which is fine. Bill Militia, Spear Militia, and a general, which is probably camping, I would assume. I think he is. Yes, he is. He is camping in the center of the battle of the map. So I'm going to fast forward until we get to the gate, because you know what it's like. It's repetitive. It's kind of boring and... Yeah, it's fine. The militia, of course, being used as the main force to batter the gate down because they can be thrown away, so we don't mind taking damage to them. And we're in. Look at that. Hell yeah. Give me a hell. Give me a yeah. Oh, shit. Let's go back to normal mode. Let's drop the shit there. Let's get these dudes in place. Welsh militiamen can go for the charge on the heavy infantry first. They can be the meat shield, and it's time to give them a big grind with the rest of my forces. Now they are heavy infantry. They do have spearmen on the wall, so we are going to have to be a little bit careful with our cav. Militia ran away, that's fine for all I care. We got the gate open and that's all I cared about, really. The general's gonna go for it. Oh shit, actually no, the general better not go for a charge. We could, I suppose. How many men do they have in this general? Can't really tell from here. Probably the same, I would assume, as 21. The same as me, so... We're going to go for a charge anyway with the general. All the spears can charge through. And my general can actually charge through as well. Come on, get your ass out there, dude. Rodri, get out. I hate these meshes, camp. Really annoys me. There we go. We've taken a couple of them out. They are pursuing me. But the rest of my force can charge them. Oh shit, general, get up there, you fucking moron. Oh shit, stay up there. You're in the right place in the first place. Oh no, we're trapped. Pfft, fuck. Shit, this is bad. Get the general back. You can go for a charge in the bum. Charge the bum. It's usually good. Go a bit quicker though. Don't like it when you go slow. I like my men fast. Attack the spearmen. Pull through the general. Holy shit, we are routed in one of the spear militia. The only militia. Fuck, my general's gonna die. Get out. Quick. Through. Charge. That's good enough. Spears, get onto their horses, please. We are winning this battle relatively easily, although I'm making it look hard. Lost that there. Get the fuck out of my way, you stupid screens. And now, of course, we are routing a spearman. Get in here, lads. Come on, charge. Charge. Kill the spears. Building captured. That's great. My general dude can actually go and be a dude and capture this thingy-majiggy over there. Make yourself useful, lad. I want to kill the general. So fucking get up there and kill him. Boars can attack. Oh, militia's back. They can charge well. This spear route in 28 left. Heavy infantry defeat is a distinct possibility. No, no, my friend. It is very likely indeed.
Our foolish general has thrown his life away. Perhaps our chances of victory with it. The enemy are badly bloodied. They have lost half their men.
Oh, poppycock. That was shit. Uh-oh. How the hell? I thought he... What the fuck? Oh no, this is bad. I lost my general, I can't believe that. Rodri's dead. That was careless. I clicked over there, that's not fair. Man, unless he must have gone right into the spheres, the retard. Oh my god, I can't believe Rodri's dead. As long as I don't lose Llewellyn, I don't care. Don't want to lose Llewellyn, all the rest can die for like it. Get in there, lads. Oh my god, my throat's going. You tell us a big battle and my throat starts to get all croaky. Fast forward. Kill. Fast forward. Oh shit, we are out in two of them. Yes! End battle. Victory is ours. That'll do. Let it be a That'll do, lad. That'll do. Thank you, Oxford. You are now mine. Although I lost my general, but it doesn't matter. We took Oxford anyway. In very quick fashion. Boom. Oh, should we sack? Oh, look at the florins I can gain from looting. 7,000. Yes. I've sacked Oxford and we've got a big payout. So we are going to... we're going to stop croaking. But we are going to re-recruiting some units and constructing some bullshit from here as well. Because we need some nice bullshit rather than stupid bullshit that we've been taking from Wales. So, Rodri's dead. May you rest in peace. God bless you, my son. Bloody bloody blah. Okay, so we've taken Oxford, and that's another lovely settlement that I've taken. Look at that map, green and red all over the place. We are taking loads and loads of English places, and I'm surprised the Barons Alliance. Well, not surprised, but it's funny because they haven't really actually spawned on the map yet, and that's because we've been too good, we've been too quick, and they just can't cope with our speed at the moment. The way we've done this campaign, to think that we started off with Carnarvon, Montgomery, and Pembroke, and just blitzed basically Chester, Shrewsbury, Gloucester, Cardiff in the first like three turns and just gone bang bang bang, and then we went bang to Shaftesbury, bang to wherever, we went to Winchester, we've gone to Launceston, we've just taken everything within sight. Now we have our sights set on Arundel. Now my spy can be useful here and actually go a bit further across for me if I quicken him up slightly, just to see if anything's hiding around here in case they do attack me, that's what I'm trying to say. I can't get my words out properly, I'm talking gibberish again. Now this spy is going to be useful, he's going to go up here. It's a port here, I think this is actually a settlement. This is all London, that's London's port. I think there's a settlement up here. East Anglia, I think it's Ipswich or Norwich, I can't remember which one it is. They're both the same, not both the same, both different places, but they're both in the same area, that's what I'm trying to say. Right, so we're taking Oxford, they've got a little army which should probably attack me, but we might be able to hold, or should hold. Need to recruit some more crap from here. Catapult Maker, that would be nice, wouldn't it? We don't need that because we've got Shrewsbury and thingy not far away for that. Brothel, Public Order, upgraded Leather Tanner. I'm going to get one here, I think, and then Church, Brothel. We'll just get the Leather Tanner for now. I don't want to waste money, do I? I want to be blasting units out of my arse, basically. That's the aim. Now, Gloucester's probably a good one to get them from because it's quite near to where I need to get a unit. So let's get some more Spearmen and Gwent Raiders. Oh my god, let's get... Yeah, we get three units coming from here. That'd be nice. We can get some mailed knights. Let's get two mailed knights from here. Need some more cavalry. We definitely need more cavalry. We're hardly... Only cavalry we've been reusing is probably my... well, whatever it's called. My general's bodyguard. That's what I'm trying to say. My god, I can't speak properly. What's going wrong? Let's get a bit more line of sights just to see. Yeah, that's fine. So we need to take this settlement, English city up here, I think. Got some Scottish influence there as well. York is there. Newcastle is there. So Carlisle, Newcastle, York, that's three. Okay. Lincoln is four. That's right, it's four. There's one up here, so it's five. Six for Nottingham, seven for London, and Arundel for eight. There's eight settlements remaining, I believe, which I think is eight. It might be nine, actually. Let's check. Did Newcastle. I think it's either eight or nine, right? And we have, I lost count what we have. We have, let's see, seven, plus five, 12. We have slightly more than... than our English counterparts. Of course, they probably have this up here, which I forgot about. Dublin. Ah, of course, Dublin, which you need to take. So eventually we will be trying to build a navy from somewhere. Do I have a port? Do I have a port? Oh, we have a fishing village in Launceston, which we could get a port here. Well, actually, we can't. Oh, wait a minute. What can we get? No, we can't. Fuck. Shaftesbury. Oh, I have one in Winchester, I think. If I do, it'd be awesome. Come on, show me.
Show me the ropes.
Yeah, we have a port. That's good. We can actually recruit some ships from here. Get me the cogs. Cogs of war. We can start thinking about this. They can be sent to my port in Cardiff. Oh, I have a Cardiff fishing village. Oh my god. I think I failed already. I could have upgraded this. Oh, and get some spear militia. Oh, don't want spear militia, do we? Montgomery, what can you give me on this fine day? We can give us some more Maronite spearmen. Do we want Maronites? We need the infantry, don't we? So let's get one of them. No, I'm not going to bother with hell weirdly crap, to be honest. Carnarvon, you can give me the good units. You give me the good stuff. Give me the good stuff. Scythewyr bowmen. Get two of them and give me a Rafelwyr axeman. We can get two little skirmishers. We haven't used these and we're not going to with these shit. All I need to say about them, they are shit. I mean, oh my fucking god. We've actually got a port up here. I don't think, can I recruit a ship from here? Yeah, I can, even though they blockade it. Cog. They can have, get a Hulk from there. It doesn't matter. Anyway, so I think we are at the end of turn phase. Now, I probably need to start thinking about taking Carlisle soon. And starting to consolidate the north. So probably recruiting units from here would be beneficial. English male knights. Oh my god, they're 740 from here. That's not worth it at all. I can't get any infantry from here either, which is shocking. I can get some... I'll upgrade them anyway, and then... English male... Billmen, yeah. And we'll use this unit. We haven't used Welsh skirmishers, I don't think, so we'll get one of them. Make sure... Oh, peasants. Fucking. Yeah, let's get a peasant unit, why not? They can stick. They can stay back in Lancaster while I go to Carlisle. And Chester, of course, is reinforcing. This army could have gone up here, but I need to have this big army nearby in case that big dude, which I think has gone to Nottingham at the moment, has gone there. So we have a few... things just to double check. I think we are okay though. Yeah, we're staying outside the fort there. Diplomat, gonna go there. Merchant is, that's fine. And then my diplomat is actually gonna come south. Where is he? Madog is gonna come south for me. He can scout out these northern regions for me as well on the way down. And the Baron's Alliance might form anyway, but I don't think they will. I think I've taken too many of the settlements for that script to actually run, so. We might be okay. So let's click the end turn. We're on 15 turns now and we are gathering well. And England, are they going to attack me? Oh, fucking hell, they are indeed. Generals come up. Which general is this? Who are you? Unfortunately, my ballistas aren't there. I need to get them there, don't I? They haven't attacked me, which is even better. So I can actually attack them. A guild, a thieves guild. Oh my crap. Should we get a thieves guild? Why not? In Oxford? No, not in Oxford. We might lose Oxford, and that'd be a waste of 1,000, so no point. Mission success, so I've been rewarded 2 male knights at your capital, which of course is Cardiff. Male knights, how good to see you. I need you quickly. Get your asses to Gloucester. Gloucester, I can take a nice little army. Give me them. You're pushing out towards Oxford. 2 turns to get there. Look at that, it's quite good. Gwent Raiders. Merinoise Spearmen. Male knights. Hellbeer Bowman, yes. Nice little... small stack for me there. Now, Shrewsbury. My ballistas won't get there. Oh, fucking hell. It's going to be awkward, right, isn't it? My billmen can get to there. And these need to come out. Prince Edward. Prince! Oh my god, we can fight in the prince. Prince Edward the Wrathful. The factionary can be killed by a bunch of nobodies. I'm going to sally out and fight this battle. I'm just going to readjust myself in my chair because my arse is hurting. There we go, that's a lot better. I need to get a gaming chair because I'm using a very uncomfortable chair at the moment. It really hurts your bum. My bum is hurting. Not in a rude way, that sounds rude. You know what I mean, guys, I'm not being dirty. Fucking hell, dirty bastards. Okay, let's attack Arendelle with the king. Oh my god, the king. Oh fucking hell. Yeah, let's attack. We can assault straight away as well with the king. Take Arendelle from these poor bastards. Come on. Oh my god. They're actually favourites, even though we have all the shit in our favour. A nighttime attack it is, but we... Oh my god, what do we want to do? Withdraw. Slightly withdraw. I feel better knowing they've got more men. We're going to besiege with the king, and we're going to try and take the prince in this turn. That's our plan for the mission thing. Oh, and we can actually reinforce Winchester with Edwin Riddirk, which he will with a couple of English billmen. Units, get him in position, which can reinforce. Winchester is unhappy. I don't give a shit, really. Winchester can suck my cock. My red Welsh cock, for all I care. I'm only joking. My God, I'm getting really dirty. You know, it's not nice. I know there's a couple of people out there probably offended by my bad language, and I'm sorry. Okay, let's get back to being serious. Okay, so I need to take this fort if I'm going to get past them, which I can probably do relatively easily with the blister anyway. So what do we want to do? We could just reinforce them with all my good units. I think I'm happy to sit there for now. They're not going to do anything to me. They can't really, if they move out and try and go for Shaftesbury, I can just get them with my army from Gloucester. I got nice units going towards Oxford, so I need to defend Oxford first. My ships, I could actually, there's no point blockading the port if I'm about to take it, so you need to think of that. My spy can actually go up here for me, and there's Norwich. I was right, it's Norwich. I knew it was either Norwich or Ipswich. And it's actually undefended. It's got two blisters and a cavalry unit, so it's not too much of a problem, really. I can actually take London. Oh my God, I could take London with Captain Howell. I don't have ballista, though. Oh, I gotta do it, don't I? Maintain the siege. I could take London, I could take Oxford, and I could take Arundel, all within this part. I'm gonna have this as a long part. The aim is trying to take out the English by part 20. And then I'll probably pause the campaign at that stage. Concentrate on all the Attila Total War stuff, because that'll be out in February. And then continue this campaign in the summer when I try and take on Ireland and Scotland and Norway. Basically, I'm going to have a domination campaign where I take everything. That will be the idea anyway. But of course, the problem with that is once you get to a certain stage, you know you're going to win the campaign and it becomes easy. But I'll still try and show you some tips and stuff. Anyway, enough about that bullshit. My general could take this fort from the rebels, but they're rebels. I don't really care about the rebels, so we're going to move on. Oh, I could go north, could go south. Oh, right, this is what I was going to do, wasn't it? I wanted to take stuff out of Lancaster. Let's take them all out of Lancaster. Fuck Lancaster. Let's get out of there. Let's take this fort, first of all. In the fort, head towards Carlisle in the north. Need to recruit units, which we are. Peasants and shit. Skirmishers. Take another skirmisher unit, why not? We'll have more units in Lancaster shortly. Chester's undefended, but I've got this dude on the way. English capital, I haven't got... Oh God, have I got enough for the English capital? I doubt it. I need to check my family, because I haven't really checked my family much. Show family tree. Yeah, so I've still got the prince alive, and I still have the king alive. I have lost Setafor Gurganai. I've lost Melirmaithi, the drunk. And I think that's it. I've lost two generals, so it's not too bad, actually. Oh, Griffith as well. Oh, no, he dies at the start of the campaign anyway, so he's already gone. So, yeah, so I lost two out of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's not bad. Not too bad. I'm trying to think, where do I need to go with this army? Because we are probably going to take Oxford. We're going to defend Oxford and get rid of these captains' armies, I think. And if not, we got ballistas, which will certainly sort things out. These armies down here are pretty safe, I think. This army's also going to go to Oxford. So basically, they'll all defend Oxford and then converge and then take out the rest of the English settlements. So I think the king can probably take Arundel, sit for a turn, replenish a few things, and then go for Norwich. Eventually, King Llewellyn's going to go to the north and take Scotland. I think if he can... How old is he? He's 32. Oh, it's a nice age. It's not a bad age. He's going to stay alive and go to the north and take Scotland, I hope. Or start the war with Scotland anyway, and perhaps his faction, A, can do the rest. So, first of all, we're going to fight this battle in Oxford. There's enough talking. We've got battles to win. So, let's sally out, lads. Let's come out with all these. And, of course, the prince... Edward the Wrathful doesn't get his reinforcing army, but I get mine, which is fan-fucking-tastic, isn't it? 57 men reinforcing 198. Slight advantage to us. Let's fight this battle and let's defend Oxford, because we need to defend this place. It's important that we keep Oxford, because it kind of... Taking Oxford nullifies the English. I surround them. I basically outflank them. That's why I got to take the north as well, to give myself a full kind of advance. And here we are. They've got to come to us. They don't have ballista, and we're going to be forming in behind them with the rest of my men. And they don't have very good units. They have mercenary crossbowmen, which can be taken out by my cavalry. And then their general's going to get speared, basically. So I'm actually going to... what do we want? We want... Okay, we just put them there, start the battle. And there we go. Reinforcements are going to be... Going to be arriving, I think. Oh, and I haven't actually got control. Oh, shit. I didn't click the options for the control. Where are they going? Are they... Don't run away from me, you cowards. bastards. I want to kill the prince. That's why I'm doing this. They are retreating, aren't they? Oh my god, you cowards. This just sums the English up. I won't get there. This is where my general is, Edwin Radich. Look how far away he is from the action. Holy crap. And he has his cavalry unit, some English bill, well, two units of English billmen, which hardly any men in the unit at all. So yeah, it's gonna be fun. I've taken everything out of the settlement. I've planned to charge. I pity I haven't got any cavalry with me right now. That would be useful. We actually get a bonus if we fight this. If we fight in the, oh shit, here we go. I'm gonna send my militiamen there. I'm gonna group up these two units. They're gonna go straight for the general, and then the third unit can go for this unit. This is awful dangerous, but because I've got my general and two units of English billmen, I'm quite happy. They'll probably go to my settlement. We should win this. I would be surprised if we didn't win it, personally. Problem is, they're going to keep running away from us, which I don't like. This is better. This is better. We got the crossbowmen tangled up in a infantry battle with my spearmen, which is what I wanted initially. The militiamen can do that. The cavalry's just sitting there for some reason. Don't know why they would. They're going to be impaled by spears before long. Now I need to break off all the spearmen and the militiamen, and now I can outflank them. Bugger the crossbowmen. We're doing a good job to try and tie the heavy cavalry. Militiamen can charge in. Turn that off and charge. Of course they are going to attack the militiamen. Probably rout the militiamen as well, which isn't a problem really. I can afford to lose them, it's not a problem. I wish them the mercenary crossbowman here would die though, because it would sit there causing problems for me, or slight problems for me at the moment. Oh, this is fine though, it's not a problem really. My bowman can actually aim for their crossbowman, tie them up in a battle while this unit can fight away at the crossbowman. Balance force is even apparently, which you wouldn't believe because we are spearmen, although we are doing better now. How are we doing? Just 18 left. Interesting, right. Edwin needs to be aggressive. I hate the fact. Oh shit. I hate the fact that Edwin is kind of being a dick at the moment. I can't control him, which I should have unchecked that. That was stupid. But I didn't really look at it, and I'm going to pay, I think. Oh my god. Problem is, cavalry can just run away from me, and they are actually. Victory is apparently certain to them. Come on. The enemy are badly bloodied. Oh shit. Oops, I paused on accident. Play. Get back in there, lads. Take out the fucking cavalry, come on. If we can keep tying up the cavalry, then we are going to be okay. We've routed the one unit of mercenary crossbowmen. Just the cavalry remaining. Need to get in there quickly, come on. I want to kill the prince, that's what I'm doing. They would be foolish to attack me. This guy needs to get up here. What's he doing? Is he just camping? Oh, please don't say you're camping. I'd be so annoyed, you know. You're just taking fucking forever. Why can't I control you? Oh my god, I can't believe this. Our foolish oh, fuck. Thrown his life away. You gotta be kidding me. Perhaps our chances of victory with it. Oh, you're joking. They're all running away, you bloody idiots. I've got to rely on the AI, I can't believe this. All because I didn't check something at the start of the battle. And look at this, I've only got 44 and 8. Like I said, the ballista's going to be the key for me, I think, in this battle. Fortunately, we have quite a bit of ammunition left. Hopefully, we won't get charged by the general. 8 remaining. May as well aim for the crossbow. Oh, 7 remaining. We've actually took out a horse then. Which is very good for me. Only 7 there. Can do less damage. Oh, my God, they ran away. Fuck's sake. Rally our men before all is lost. Ah, no. Can I control my... Shit. Were they... They should be foremined in the settlement, I would have thought. They would run back to the capture point and... Can this guy walk any slower? Holy shit. I can't believe this is happening. Oh my God. And they're marching like a bunch of pricks. It's taking forever. I'm gonna fast forward this, I think. I may have to quit the battle. Just gonna fast forward. See what happens. Right, the general's gonna go out. I'm gonna see what the general does. I hope they don't lose my general, because that would be unfair. I mean, I've weakened them enough. He should be enough for them. I mean, there's only 7 horses and a bunch of crossbowmen. General should be good enough. Edwin Redditch. Live up to your name. I've actually got some units back now, so we're gonna run them out just in case. Fast forward again. Some bow units have come out for me as well. They can run out. Like I expected, my units are coming back to me, which is fantastic. Let's go to normal speed. Let's get everything up to attack. Hopefully my general will charge. Oh my God, he's not charging. Oh, no, he is. Get the plus one. There we go. Charge.
Our noble allies have lost their leader. Without their general, they may lose heart and flee.
Yeah, I've done it. Did they say I lost my general? I'd be so pissed off if I have. You know, on the first charge as well. Oh my goodness. Right, keep charging. You're doing the job. They are. They got 7 left. We have 14. Just charge, run for them, fast forward, double their number, we should do it. I got a decent general in Edwin as well. Aren't they going to run away? Oh, look at the cowards running away. Shameful. Shameful display.
Behold how our
end battle.
This is a clear victory.
Well, that was painful. I hope I haven't lost my general. I know that the captain died, but I'm hoping that the actual general didn't die then. I think he did, though. Ransom these, subjected. Oh, you kidding me? He's fucking dead! Oh my God. I didn't even control him when he's dead. That pisses me off. Jesus. Let's get some spear militia in here quickly to help reinforce. Gonna get a leather tanner here and get some land clearance as well, because why not? Why the hell not? Oh, the English have Oh my God, I want to kill him. Winchester's wide open, although we got some units on the way, so I'm not too concerned. There'll be no, we go for the units there. Ballista's on the way as well. Oxford will be evaluated. And where am I going now? Well, something I was going to do, I think I was going to bring my spy near to Nottingham to see what your Edmund is there. Right, Lincoln's open. I'm probably wise to use this army to go there.
As you wish.
Deep into English territory. Tomorrow, some armoured sergeants, they seem to be careful of them. Lincoln could be taken again. Could try and take Lincoln again and then try and flank Nottingham. Cause some problems. London, actually besieging London and besieging Arundel. So we're going to fight this battle of Arundel first. So assault this time. And of course, this is a bit bullshit. We're going to go for a night battle and we're going to fight this one ourselves. We've got ballista and we've got catapult. We're going to be probably fast forward in this battle because I'm going to be using up all my ballistas and catapults to actually attack England's gates and then attack the English units before I charge in. Weaken them as much as I can. That's kind of the aim. Just start deployment. Let's get my ballista into a very decent position. And everything else. Actually, just get everything up close and then just get these two like that. That'll do. And they can both attack the gatehouse there. My units are actually taunting them. Look at that. Look at that lovely bullshit right there. Holy crap. And they're all camping, which is even better because I can actually... I think that's all they have anyway, are these two units. Which would be great because I can take them out quite easily. Oh, just going to readjust myself in my chair because my bum is still hurting. Oh, man. There we go. We're going to get some shots away, hopefully. Not waste too much ammunition. This should be quite easy to take, I would think. I'm going to fast forward now. Because it's going to be boring otherwise. We'll get in shortly. There we go. Just going to fast forward. Go back normal speed. Get my archers grouped up. Bring them a bit closer to the action. Bring the cavalry a bit closer to the action as well. And my crossbowmen. Mercenary crossbowmen I'm using as well. Don't think I've used mercenaries yet. This is the first time in the campaign I'm using them. Because I don't see the point in them, but I did it just in case, because this is the king after all, and that's one guy I don't want to lose. I won't keep Llewellyn all the way through the campaign if possible. Unless he dies of old age or something, then that would be kind of sad, but you know what I mean, right? So there we go, we're actually in now, so it's going to grab both of these units, and we're actually going to get them to fire upon the units here. Shaking in their boots, probably. Probably shaking in their boots. While that's going on, I can bring my missile troops. I'm actually going to group these three together. Oops, and let's get a decent formation with them as well. Make it loose, in case. I don't know if their towers are actually going to fire upon me. I don't think they are they? Should be okay. Might be okay, I think. They're going to go there, and then all my infantry can be grouped up. There we go, lovely jubbly. Get that in the line as well. And my infantry is actually going to make it into the gatehouse, I think. So we might want to start bringing them forward about there to begin with. General can come up as well. Bringing everything up, we are going to take Arundel, and that will be another settlement for the Welsh. We're doing fantastic at the moment. I think we are doing a pretty sterling effort in this campaign. We've had some fantastic battles and some great moments, and long may it continue. I'm actually going to bring this unit of ballista in and have the units then behind it to intercept in case they charge. That's probably a decent idea. I'm going to get all my bow units now to come forward. I'm going to fast forward now that I have a general plan. Don't want to take losses if I can help it. That's my aim. There we go, we've captured the enemy's walls. Don't want my units to go too close, so they can actually come back now. Dudes, get back. Bliss is in a good range, got good range from here, I think, so let's do that. How close are my infantry? Oh, they're not too far away. I may have to charge them in if they do attack me. And these guys are firing now as well. Just hope I don't shoot my own men. I think I might actually be shooting my own men from here, so I may have to be careful. Get the hell of your bowmen up there. Crossbowmen can stay because they're disposable. We're just going to send archers on the flanks. Ballista's firing. Catapult is firing. Mercenary crossbowmen are firing. It's all going well, and of course the general's charging. So it's now time for us to bring our infantry forward. Boom! We got some shots, got some kills. The infantry's going to be met by my infantry in an epic last stand here at Arundel. Oh, and they're cowering away. Look at that, the fucking cowards that they are. I have no need to actually pursue them. They can camp there and we can just keep picking them off. We have ballista on the way anyway, and we are killing them. Look at that. Another horse. A couple of horses taken out, which we love. love it when we start doing damage to them. And now it's time to kill the general's bodyguard. Get in there, spearman. Not the best of charges as well, which is good for us. We kind of counteracted their charge, and we're all going to send everything in now to them. To meet and greet, of course, the armored sergeants are going to be fired upon. My bowmen can flank now from this side and start firing upon them. If we remain true and good tidings, there we go, dead. Hell yeah. This is awesome news for us, of course. The enemy general is dead, so he's not going to be a problem, and we can just continue to charge. And now I'm going to tell my bowmen to actually stop. Oh, we can end the battle there. So there we go. Only lost 5 men. That's even better. So perfect victory for us with 5 losses. That's very acceptable indeed. And we have taken Arundel. The king has taken Arundel, King of Wales. And I might exterminate these guys as well. I'm just going to keep exterminating everyone now, I think. We're deep in English territory. I could sack. He has granted us victory. I could just occupy. I'm going to exterminate. Why not? Resistance is futile. And we can repair the castle for 32 florins. We can retrain the mercenary crossbowmen, which I might actually disband eventually, so we're not going to bother retraining them. Knight stable might be good for mailed knights, but we don't think we need it at the moment. Small chapel maybe. Public order and cultural conversion bonus would be useful, so we'll get that instead to help the culture, because we are only 4% Welsh. And then leather tanner for the units, because we can recruit some heavy English billmen, English spearmen, so we're going to be recruiting some of them, I think, from Arundel. Now, finally, we've defeated the units. Oh, well, we didn't defeat them, but they ran away, didn't they? But we defended Oxford, we've taken Arundel, now it's time for us to take London. Well, we can't do it yet, we have to maintain the siege. We haven't got siege equipment, unfortunately, which is terrible, because we could have maybe taken London this part. It's not a problem, though. We can probably do something about that, my diplomat. Yes, my oops, shit. Let's go and talk to Scotland for a bit. Would you like an alliance? They would. Okay, so we won't bother with that then in that case. I'm not going to get any sort of alliances with anyone. I'm just going to be doing my own thing, really. Tomorrow's journey planned out. And, of course, we've got these guys now which tomorrow's want to attack Carlisle. Yes. And they shall be aggressive. No point sitting back. That's the point I'm trying to emphasize. So the Prince of Wales, not me, not Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales, Davith, is going to attack Carlisle for us. Lancaster is a bit pissed off, but they are getting units next turn, which is great. So there we go, we're on turn 16. We will hopefully take Carlisle in turn 17. We will hopefully take London. And then there's only very few things left for us to take, and we should hopefully... There's a region here, I think, isn't there? Canterbury. We must take Canterbury. We can take Canterbury. They're actually 2% Norwegian, surprisingly. The king will take Canterbury as well. He can take all of these southern regions. I want to know where that Anselm of Bapton has gone. He's hiding somewhere. I know he is. Edmund is there. The King Henry is there, and the prince is hiding in his fort. So they are... He is here somewhere. I haven't fought him yet, which is a bit disappointing, because I wanted to fight him. But there we go. So I'm going to end turn, and then we'll probably... Actually, no, we're going to save the game here, and we're going to end this episode here. And then we can take the next part then in this campaign, which I think is part 13. The next part will be. This is part 12. We can finally have our battle at London, and we can finally try to expand and continue the war against the English. But I'm going to end this episode here. So I've been Dragonheart, the Prince of Wales. Thank you for watching. Until next time, goodbye.